Hello everyone, my name is Mr. Hurricane. Welcome back to Madden 16 Draft Champions. I am beginning another new season, and I'll take Tom Coughlin as my coach this time around. And now I'll see if I can top the team that I had in my last couple videos, where I won my first Draft Champions Championship. And we kick things off with three very good players: Cam Chancellor, Dez Bryant, and Vontae Davis. And you guys know I always prioritize secondary. I'll go Vontae Davis. In round two, we go down to a couple 70s and an 80 overall. And honestly, these two defensive backs aren't a big enough step above my current defensive backs to ignore Derek Newton. So I take him, and now Adrian Peterson, Sebastian Vollmer, or Rob Gronkowski. My decision will probably surprise you, but I go with Rob Gronkowski, assuming I can find another running back later, and now I have a matchup nightmare for my opponents. We go back to some golds: Charles Tillman, Kevin Zeitler, or Mike DeVito, and I will go with Kevin Zeitler, giving me two offensive linemen on the right side. We're into round five: Rolando McClain, Rob Ninkovich, or Antoine Bethea. Bethea has the highest overall. He's a good, strong safety, can cover in zone, and he fits my team style, so it's a pretty easy decision. And now I have two defensive backs, and you guys know I try to go for four. Round six, I have two players who fit my style: Orlando Franklin or Zach Ertz. I run a lot of twin tight end in Draft Champions, so I'll grab my second tight end right now. It's going to be Zach Ertz and Rob Gronkowski. We go to round seven. I still need a quarterback and a running back. LeSean McCoy's there. Travis Kelce is also there. And Xavier Rhodes. The Viking fan in me cannot let this one slip. Xavier Rhodes and Vontae Davis will form a very strong duo for me at cornerback. Round eight: Philip Rivers, Arian Foster, or Evan Mathis. And I just get so scared now of being stuck with one of the base quarterbacks. So I'm going to take Philip Rivers while I can. We jump to round 9, Gerald McCoy, Mike Evans, or Carlos Dansby. I haven't taken a linebacker yet, and Dansby's a very good run stopper. Mike Evans is an awesome playmaker on Madden 16, but I always try to get Gerald McCoy if he pops up, so I take him. He also fits my style. Round 10, Dan Williams, Joe Staley, or Cameron Hayward. Because he fits my style and will go great next to Gerald McCoy, I will take Dan Williams and get that team style up to a 72. Round 11, CJ Mosley, Alteron Werner, and Dante Whitner. I haven't taken a linebacker yet. CJ Mosley is way too good to pass up. But I'm still sitting here. I have a quarterback, no running back, and no wide receivers. I don't get one here in round 12 either. I'll take Bruce Irvin, who can be a nickel pass rusher and weak side linebacker for me. But I only have a few picks left to go. And I don't get anybody on offense here in round 13. And so there's the Honey Badger, Tyrann Mathieu. I have to take him. That's my fourth defensive back, so I'm pretty comfortable there with my defense as a whole at this point. And in round 14, my offense is still not going to get any help. Ndamukong Suh is right there. I don't have a need for him really with Dan Williams and Gerald McCoy, but Ndamukong Suh is just so good. Can I play him at end and still be successful? We're going to give it a shot. Three defensive tackles, we're going to figure this out. And then round 15, no receiver, no running back. I don't need Rod Woodson. Walter Jones is there, but I need an offensive playmaker. So it's going to be Shannon Sharp to round this team out. And I have a weird looking team. No defensive ends and no wide receivers. And so I had to improvise. Zach Ertz and Rob Gronkowski play wideout. Shannon Sharp plays tight end. Kyrie Robinson is the type of running back I like to use, so I'm okay having him, but will I have much of a ground game now? Either way, I have some big targets on the outside. It's a little unorthodox, but we'll see how things go. I'm on defense first. I'm up against a Russell Wilson and Joe Horn, and Wilson's first pass on the day is complete to a familiar face to me, Greg Olsen. On second down, now he goes to the ground and takes this to the outside, and that is a first down to the 35-yard line. He has LeSean McCoy, whom I passed on in my draft. Now he wants to go deep, and Xavier Rhodes will lock down Joe Horn and pick it off. I knew I couldn't pass on Xavier Rhodes, and I think he plays beyond what his 82 overall suggests. But now, we want to see this weird offense I've constructed, as I will try to run the football. Not sure how the passing game is going to go, so I'll try to run it, but Kyrie Robinson is stopped for a loss on second down. That takes us to third down. I have four tight ends on the field. Here's Chase Ford, one of the tight ends I didn't draft, and he picks up a first down. You're going to see a lot of these four tight end looks. Play action this time as I go deep for Chase Ford, the Minnesota Viking and former Miami Hurricane making plays. But we'll go to our drafted tight ends as well. There's a quick pass to Rob Gronkowski for a handful. Now a third down and four. Back to pass, single coverage downfield, and wide open is Cody Latimer. This drive was highlighted by two guys I didn't even draft. Now we go back to defense, and I read that screen from the get-go and wrap up LeSean McCoy for a loss. Second down and 11 now for Russell Wilson, as I'm playing a zone, and he finds his man underneath, Tyrann Mathieu, and that's a gain of 24 yards. We are approaching the two-minute warning, and here's McCoy on the ground trying to break this outside. Almost jukes out Tyrann Mathieu and gets to my 47. Two-minute warning has hit. It's a play action on third down, and the pass over the middle is intercepted by Aaron Ross. I go backwards a little bit, but I had the football once again. Plenty of plays being made by my base roster, but now I'll go to my legend card. There's Shannon Sharp. We'll see if he does better than Brian Finneran did for me. But now I go play action, and we're going to get Rob Gronkowski on the dig. Let's see if these tight ends can play true receiver. First down and 10, back to the air again. Long for Gronkowski, and he makes the catch inside the 25. Rivers is 7 of 7. Maybe this strategy was a really smart idea. Quick screen. Ertz gets some help from Chase Ford, and he's gone. Try out those wide receiver screens where the tight end blocks the corner. If they're blitzing that linebacker, you've got some room. But we'll go back to defense, and that aggressive catch is not going to work. And so 19 seconds left. I'm comfortably up 14-0, but Wilson takes off, and he slides ahead of the 50-yard line. My opponent has one timeout remaining. I'm playing zone again. He wants to attack it deep, but overthrows Joe Horn. Xavier Rhodes was in coverage. We're now inside of 10 seconds. And he takes off on second down with Russell Wilson. First down and more as he heads out of bounds with 1 second remaining. He then attempted a 53-yard field goal and drilled it. So it's a 14-3 game, and I have possession to begin the second half. I want that screen again, but this time Ford had to block a linebacker, so Ertz will create some extra yardage himself. I'll take that. Third down and 5. Rivers outside to Rob Gronkowski once again, who has ran these digs pretty effectively. Now I'm trying to get him with a hard count, and I do draw a flag. So I have a free play and nobody going deep. I'll take my 5 yards for free as I draw Clay Matthews offsides. And I'm having a lot of fun with these tight ends, actually. And now here we go to the pause menu. Maybe he's putting all his tight ends at receiver. Or maybe he's quitting the game. That's the first time somebody's quit against me after being drawn off sides with the hard count. So that's a 1-0 start as we head into game 2. And I'm going deep this time. Gronkowski makes the catch, and he's going to go all the way. I like having Gronk at receiver. That's a 79-yard touchdown catch to begin game 2 with this tight end team. But after that touchdown, my fortunes began to change. My opponent goes long and he hooks up with his receiver, sprinting inside the 20, one man to beat, but he spins inside and Xavier Rhodes catches him from behind at the 2. He would then score and make it 7 apiece. I ended up punting and my opponent takes over, goes to the ground game and runs inside for 12 yards with Mark Ingram. And by the way, this game was actually pretty laggy. But he goes outside here to Larry Fitzgerald. I'm having trouble containing the ground game and figuring out how to cover his receivers. From the 2, slant, caught, Larry Fitzgerald, 6 points. Now I'm down by 7, have to rebound a bit. Back to pass on first down, and that's behind my tight end, Shannon Sharp. A bad throw off the back foot. Completely my fault, and my opponent takes over already up by 7, and he finds his receiver over the middle. He was beating me with James Hanna and Dontrell Inman. He scored another touchdown to make it 21-7, And I'm going to go back to Rob Gronkowski. Nice screen pass here as we're already approaching halftime. So I was trying to act quickly. Over the middle, a catch for Cody Latimer as I'll use my second timeout. Spreading the field. Rivers going up top, and there's Gronkowski at the one with just a few seconds left. So now I've got to go for the touchdown. I will run it with Matt Asiata, and he's there to stuff it and deny me of points at the end of the first half. And it didn't get much better with my opponent having the ball to begin the second half. He scored 21 unanswered and threads the needle downfield. As Eli Manning's looking pretty good. Screen pass. I'm not ready for it. He's picking up his blocks. Runs into the open field, and I lay a hit stick with Antoine Bethea, but I need a turnover. I need something to get me back in this game. And an aggressive catch by Larry Fitzgerald is exactly what I don't need. As Eli's 10 of 11 in this one, and then throws a touchdown on first and goal. 28-7 as we begin the fourth quarter. I'm not giving up, however. I'll still try to get back in this game as there's a dig by Zach Ertz and he makes the catch for a first down. And now I'm going to go to another screen pass and I throw an interception instead. Never saw him. And that's going to make it 35-7. And if you haven't figured it out by now, I got destroyed in this game. And that ended my run with my tight end squad, which was very disappointing because I would have liked to play more with this team. I may try to do this tight end build again at some point in the future, and I didn't feel like having Ertz and Gronkowski at receiver had me at much of a disadvantage, so I'll definitely try this again at some point. Here is the bronze head-to-head reward pack I received. This was actually my 10th badge for draft champions, and that led me to finish my double elite pack set. Which means in my next episode of Ultimate Team, which is going to be posted later today, you will see me open that double elite pack and play my first game with those players in Mutt. And the pack was definitely worth it. Check that video out. Also, stay tuned for more Draft Champions. I've played more since this session. I have more gameplays ready to be edited and put into videos. So, plenty more on the way. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video despite only one win in this session of Draft Champions. It was a fun team and I wanted to share it. Please leave a like if you enjoyed the video, comment below your thoughts on today's video and the team I constructed, and subscribe for much more Madden 16 Draft Champions and other Madden 16 content. Have a great day, guys. I will see you next time.